Hello, welcome to Times of Lore on the Commodore 64. Now this is a action-orientated RPG from Origin. It's not anywhere near as sort of hardcore as Ultima. And you could say it's... Well, I guess your Ultima fans might sort of turn their nose down at this, to be honest. But as far as I'm concerned, this is quite a good game. Sort of more my cup of tea, a bit more action in it than a lot of games from Origin. But okay, let's. At the minute, we're listening to a nice tune by Martin Galway. This is probably one of the last games that he worked on. Well, certainly one of the last full price games he worked on. I think he worked on Insects in Space. These must be the last two games that ring a bell for me, anyway. But let's get started. Now, when this I'm putting the disc version here, but it did actually come out cassette, and this is the version that I owned back in the day. And surprisingly, for a game of this complexity and this size, the main game is actually a single load, which is obviously as well as an impressive technical feat, is much appreciated for your cassette user. What happens is there's an introduction load, which is this load, which gives you a bit of background story. I'll just skip through it here, but the main gist of it is the king has been gone for a long time, and the land is falling into a bad state. The steward isn't doing a very good job of keeping the land together. And it's a prediction that the king will return. You can read through the story in your own time. The prediction is that the king will return and bring glory to the land again. This is where we come into it. You can pick one of three main characters, a knight, maiden warrior, or a warrior, and I normally tend to go for the knight, to be honest, because he's quite strong. He's got quite a lot of, because he's armor, he's wearing armor. He's quite strong, but he's a bit slow to walk around. But yeah, he's still bearable. But the So after this load is complete, it loads in the main game, which is a single load until you complete the game, in which case there's an outro load, but and if I remember on cassette, one side was the intro and character generation, but another load was the main game. So you just had to load the main game, really. Just load that side. Right, here we are. Welcome to Times of Lore. Now you start off at the inn in the main town. I can't remember what it's called, but I think it was the Frothing Slosh Tavern, I think, if I remember. So when you save a game, you go to an inn and ask for lodgings, and that's it. Then you're prompted to insert a cassette or disc. And when you load it in, you obviously start where you left off. The best way to get information is to talk to the barman, or sometimes you can talk to villagers as well, but you can start a bit of chit-chat. The game is played with a one-button joystick, but you have to press spacebar to activate this menu at the bottom, which you can examine items or talk to people, see what you're carrying, or use items. So it's on the right-hand side of the screen is a candle, which represents your life force. So if we just talk to the barman, get a bit closer. You can ask him about rumours. Sometimes you can ask about rumours. This is a good way to find out what's happening in the kingdom and a hint of where to go. But the game is played basically, it's fairly freeform, but there's a set number of missions that you have to complete, and as you complete them, it unravels more of the story, and where to go. Now, the first, your main starting point is to talk to this chap in here. Yeah, the prior says blah blah. Well, you accept the task, so you've got to get some stones from an enemy encampment. You reply, yes. And he says, yeah, great. Now, obviously, if you're playing no or kill him, you can't complete the game, so you've got to watch what you do. So I'm hungry, so this is where you can buy some provisions. You can see the interface is quite easy to use. It's quite nicely done, I think. The graphics are themselves are quite nice. All the characters have these nice high-res overlays. The scrolling itself is a bit jerky, but it's not too bad. Now, I'm controlling the knight, which is one of the slower characters, but he's okay. But what you can do is you can actually pick up some magic boots in one of the towns, and that speeds you up a lot. You can really walk, run quite fast with them. And it's well worth trying to get them soon early on in the game. So I can't remember exactly where I've got to go for these for this enemy encampment is. I think it's to the north. But, once you leave the town, enemies start to appear. Combat is a case of just hitting fire, really, to swing a sword or whatever weapon you've got. You can pick up gold from enemies to increase your wealth, which you can spend on provisions or lodgings. You can also pick up daggers that you can throw. Now the sound is a bit sparse on game, unfortunately. There's no in-game music, which would have been great, but it's just fairly. The sound effects are quite good, but they're a bit sparse. In terms of the environment. The in-game land, the map is huge. I mean, there's several towns and there's areas that are desert and there's underground dungeons to explore and all sorts of it's quite impressive for its size, I think. I'm also lost here. I can't remember exactly, but. Now, the game came with a nice manual and it also came with a map, which is quite handy. So, if you fancy playing this game, have a look on the internet and download the map first, so you know where you're going. Oh, I do. I think I'll head south actually. This isn't the way to the mission, but I'll probably show more of the game, I think. You see, once your character gets going, that it does actually go quite fast. These are. You can go in various buildings and talk to people, but trying to uncover more of the quest. Now, I've played this on. Tried the Amiga version and the Spectrum version, and both of those versions are not as good as this version. The main screen is quite small. Oops, I just hit a villager. Just killed an innocent. Never mind. Yeah, the main game area is quite small and it's quite slow. Oh, I think the town people are after me now. That's probably not the right thing to have done. I can't go to the bloody town now. No, this is the main hall where the steward lives. But, oh, can't get in. Time to do a runner, I think. Just somebody's house. Yeah, I think the Commodore 64 version is by far the best version to play. And the RPG elements, they're not particularly deep. It's more of an action RPG, and it's as a result, it's quite easy to get into. There's no, there's, you know, it's. Oh, I still am. I seem to have a reputation of being quite a bad chap now, I'm afraid. I probably wrecked what chances I have of getting anywhere in the game. Yeah, I had this on cassette back in the day. And I was a bit hesitant about buying a, a cassette-based RPG, but actually, it's very well done. It's one of the few RPG games that are, or adventure games, arcade adventures that are, is done well as this. Yeah, the old man says greetings, hello. Yeah, so you can gives you a hint. Yep. Well, I'm only really just scratching the surface of the game here. Obviously, I mean, there's quests to do and things to see. But yeah, by all means, I still recommend this. It's still quite a good game. I think I'll give this 8.5 out of 10. I think just because it's got a bit more depth than your average game. I think story itself is quite well done. I've managed to complete it back in the day. It's quite an absorbing story, and there's plenty to plenty of places to explore and things to do. Yeah, I think it's still quite a good game. Just a little jerky, but it's, I think the graphics are better than what you normally expect from these sort of games. Also, I've just fallen the road round here, and that's another way to get around the map. It's just to just follow the road to the next village, but you can wander off the beaten path and see a bit more. Right, well, that's Tombs of Lore for you. Action RPG, easy to get into, quite nice to look at. Yep, I think it's not bad at all. 8.5 out of 10.